Hello, I'm Chris Menard. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Feel free to subscribe, ring the bell. In today's Excel video, I'm going to take a look at conditional formatting, and I'm only going to pick on one category, highlight cells, rules, but I'm going to dive through every one of the different options with you. Let's go ahead and get started right now. So I have Excel running. Here is one of the most popular conditional formattings you have. I've got states in column E. I'm in cell E2, control, shift, down arrow to highlight all the states. They're all selected. That is step one. I'm on the home tab up in the top left, conditional formatting. And here's the only group I'm picking on, highlight cells rules. I'm going to actually start off with this equal to, but we'll run through every one of these. Equal to is really popular. I want to see what state I am making this up. GA, it puts it in a red background. If you don't like that red background, come over here and click. You can do yellow. You can do green. You can do whatever you want to. If you don't see more options, just come to custom format. Here is your custom format box with font, border, and the popular fill tab for conditional formatting. I'm going to just keep this simple and stay with green and hit OK. So there is conditional formatting equal to, one more equal to. Conditional formatting, highlight cells rules equal to. I also want to see California. I would pick a different color. It's already picked this light red here. You could actually, though, stick with the same green you did with Georgia. It's a matter of preference. When I hit OK, there I go. Couple quick tips now. If you want to filter or sort this, I want to sort by California, right click, filter, cell color. There's the California, undo, control, Z. Also, if you want to sort the data tab, sort, I want to do state and change this to cell color. And I'm going to stop here because I've covered this a million times. Excel is smart enough to know the two colors you used. And you can put them on top or on the bottom. So there was equal to. I usually use that with text, but you could use it with numbers or with a date field if you wanted to. Let's go back and do another one that's very similar to text. I'm going to swap worksheets just for a second. Notice in column C, I've got the street main. So I'll do this one twice again. Select first, home tab, conditional formatting. We just did equal to. Here is text that contains. Because I'm looking for Main, I don't care whether it's Main Street, Main Avenue, Main Road. I'm just typing in the word Main. I hit OK, and there it works. If I change this and make something else Main, it picks that one up also. I am going to undo that last one. Another example of text that contains. If you notice, we got a list of employees here, and in column G is their department. Some employees, though, are assigned to two departments. I want to see just people that are in marketing. So control shift down arrow. So if I did just equals to marketing, it would not be correct. This is text that contains marketing. Click OK, and there are your answers right there. Pop back over into the other worksheet. Let's keep on going. Under conditional formatting, let's do greater than, less than, and between all in one. These are usually used for dates or numbers, these three right here. I'm going to go ahead and highlight the purchases, the date. Actually, I'm going to do a quick sort first. Just to show you how this works. Okay, now I'm going to highlight purchases to date. I want to see numbers over 1,000. Highlight greater than 1,000. Again, you can change the color. Hit OK. Undo. Conditional formatting. I'm not going to do less than. It's just the opposite of greater than. But here's your between. I'm looking for people who have purchases to date between 875 and 1495. Hit OK. There I go. I want to see it real quick. I'm going to do a sort largest to smallest. 875 and 1495, I believe, it is working. Just to test this, watch this, 1372, it picks it up right there. Cool. Another tip about conditional formatting, if you want to get rid of all the rules, you go to clear rules, and you can clear the rules from the entire worksheet that you're working on, not the file, but just the worksheet. But I just want to clear rules from the selected cells, so let me just highlight this again. And I'm going to clear rules from the selected cells. So column E, the two conditional formattings, is going to stay intact. There we go. So there's conditional formatting, highlight cells rules with greater than, less than, in between. Again, dates or numbers usually for those. We've already done equal to. We've done text that contains. You would also use these for dates, the between, less than, and greater than. But here's an interesting one, a date occurring. So let me actually highlight some invoice dates over here. Conditional formatting, highlight cells, rules, a date occurring. I'm going to hit this drop down just to show you all the options you have in here. You've got this month, last month, today, yesterday, all this other stuff in here. I'm going to go with this month, and I hit OK, and sure enough, today is President's Day 220, and there are those dates. Let's just test it one more time. 2/15/2023, it picked it up. So there are your dates right there. The one we haven't discussed is also one I use all the time, and that is duplicate values. So if I want to find out what is duplicate values, let me swap over to another sheet. All right, I want to see duplicate values. Let me put somebody in production and engineering, and there we go. Control shift down arrow. I want to see duplicate values right here, and it quickly selected all the duplicate values. And here's a cool tip for you. If you say, I just want to see the unique selected, you just swap it right here from duplicate to unique. Now, let's get fancy with this duplicate value one. I'm going to delete that just to keep this clean. What if I want to know, I'm going to clear the rules real quick. What if I want to know if I've got duplicate values here for these customers? So watch what's going to happen here. I picked up the entire range except for the header row. I didn't get the header row. So if I go to duplicate values, watch what it does. That really isn't helping me a lot. And by the way, you can tell row 8, 9, 10, and 8, 9, 10 are duplicates. Got some other ones in here. But it's really hard to tell that they're duplicate. And that's also why it selected all these over here, because single, family are listed twice. So here's how I handle this one. I'm going to undo that or clear the rules. This is when TextJoin function comes in handy. So I want to just join everything together, then find the duplicate. So I'm looking for everything. TextJoin tab. I do not have a delimiter here, so I'm going to just do a comma. Ignore empty. I don't care. Comma. But here you go. What is it I'm trying to join together? I highlighted A2 to K2. I'm going to autofill it down. I'm going to leave it selected. Here are your duplicate values. This is going to be easy to see. So there are your duplicate values right here with Sandra. Cool. There you go. One more time on the duplicates. Watch this one. I have a list of first name and last name, and I did the same thing here that I just did, except I did it slightly different. Act like this full name, and this full name is not here. So I had a list of first names and last name. A and B is my main list. Column E and F are my other list, and I want to know, do I have duplicate values? The issue is when you come in here and say duplicate values, you're getting something like this, and it's just hard to see. So what I did is I went to cell C2. I typed in majors, comma, Kathy. Then I started typing in Robert, comma, Carol. And our good friend Flashville took over. So just to show you Flashville, Roberts, comma, Carol. That is flash fill right there. If it after three or four, if it doesn't pick up, do control and the letter E. Flash fill is also on the data tab up at the top, but this is correct. Just to show you exactly where it is with the mouse, data tab, flash fill, keyboard shortcut is control E. So I flash filled down all the names, the full name. I flash filled down the full names over here. Now I'm still trying to find what names are duplicated. I use the control key to select them both. Home tab, conditional formatting, duplicate values, and everything in that red background color. Those are my duplicate names from both lists right there. Hope you enjoyed this video. Feel free to subscribe. If you have any questions, please put them in the comment section down below. Appreciate your time. Thank you.